Hi, in this last video, I will talk about shifting and window functions in pandas. All right, so first of all, shifting. I want to cover two different functions for shifting. First of all, the function shift, and secondly, the function tshift. The shift function will take the data, the time series that you have, and shift the values by a certain amount. And this will actually shift like the rows down or up, depending on what value you specify. And this will lead to some data being lost at the one end and some missing values being created at the other end. So if you move the rows down, for example, then at the top you will generate some missing data, and at the bottom you will lose some data because pandas will not extend the datetime index, and it also won't cut the top part of it. So if you specify a positive number as a parameter in shift, it will move the rows down. A negative number will move them up. Okay, but for shift, the datetime index will stay the same. So it will not move the index, it will only move the data itself. If you only want to move the datetime index, you can use the tshift function, and this works similarly as shift. You also specify a period, so how far this should be shifted, negative or positive. And this will only move the index and not throw some data away and create missing data, but it will just basically slide the datetime index along the data. Okay, and to visualize this, I created these plots here, and these are just showing the first plot here, the original data, and then the second subplot shows the data shifted by 365, so by 1 year. And then the last one will show the data with a t-shift of 365. And you can see that in the original data, this goes from 2009 until, I guess, 2014. And the same datetime index is also present after we shifted. So this still goes from 2009 until 2014. But for the first year here, we have missing value, because we shifted the data back by 1 year, and then at the end, we lost some of the data, as you can see here. In the original plot, the data is, the graph is going up quite a bit, and this part of the data is lost in the shifted one. Then in the t-shift, you can see the data looks the same as in the original data, so we didn't lose any data, but now the datetime is shifted. And these red bars highlight the year 2011. And you can see that for the t-shift, this moved by 1 year to the left. And this is what t-shift does. It will just take the index and move that while leaving the data stationary. Okay, one example where this could be useful is, for example, to create a difference and use the difference of the current time, like minus the time before. And for that, we can use the shift function, for example, where we take our data frame or time series minus our time series shifted by some period. And here in this case, we set the period to 1. And if we plot this, you can see that now we always have the difference between one row and the row above. And this will show us by how much the value changed from one day to the other. And since this is quite long and complicated, pandas also offers a function which makes this shorter. This is called the diff function, so for difference. And we also specify a period here, and we can use this to just create these differences that we could also do with the shift function, but using the diff function is just simpler. And it's just one function call here without needing to manually subtract anything. All right, now coming to the window functions. I want to cover three different window functions. First of all, this is the rolling window, which you can imagine like a window with which you look at your time series data, and this will only look at a certain part of the data at one time. And then this rolling means that you start at the beginning, so at the start of your time series, and then move this window one row down every time. So the window will have the same size all the time, but it just moves, it rolls along this data. And yeah, then we can do some aggregations on these rolling windows. For example, here we are rolling with a window size of 365 and then calculate the mean for that. So we take the mean of 1 year for every window, and we move this window along our data. So if we plot this, the blue plot is the original data. As you can see, we first plot just the normal time series, and after that we plot the rolling window. You can see that in the blue plot we get the normal data, and in the orange one, yeah, this is a moving average, which takes 1 year of the data into account. Okay, but as you can see, this kind of lags behind. This is why it always takes the end of the rolling window, and yeah, just calculates this mean from 1 year before. And we can also have this yeah, center the window such that if we have a value here, it will look at like half a year before that and half a year after that, and not just take 1 year before a certain value. If we want to do this, we have to set center to true in the rolling function. And if we do this, you can see that this moving average with the centered window yeah, follows the data more closely, since we don't lag behind by a year, but are actually yeah, like at the actual position of our data. Okay, the second window is an expanding window. And here we also specify the period, the min period. And what this expanding window will do is yeah, start at the beginning of your time series with the size that we specified at minimum periods, and then gradually will get bigger and bigger and take more data into account. And this can be very useful. For example, if the time series fluctuates around the mean, and yeah, you want to capture how that progresses along with time, then you can use such an expanding window. And yeah, here we see that for this expanding window, we again start at the beginning, and yeah, we lost some data at the beginning because this minimum period says we need to 365 days to start, and then it will just yeah, expand this window and take more data into account the further we go along. Okay, then lastly, the exponential weighted window. This is very similar to the normal expanding window, but this will weight our windows based on based on where we are in the data. So this will weight more recent data more strongly than previous data, and can therefore kind of be viewed as like a smoother version of a rolling window.